At the good dog obedience school, dogs learn how to do tricks. Sit, stay, and roll over. Of the dogs at the school, 50 dogs can sit, 29 dogs can stay, 34 dogs can roll over, 9 dogs can do all three. Those guys are the super dogs. 17 dogs can sit and stay, 12 dogs can stay and roll over, 18 dogs can sit and roll over, 9 dogs can do none. Poor little dogs. Those dogs must never get the treat. When all these other dogs are eating their bones and biting on their bones, these guys are still practicing. But anyways, enough about dogs. Let's get into the picture. Well, I'm gonna use a Venn diagram, though a very special one. So the kind we know, a big Venn diagram. Because we're gonna put a lot of writing in it. We're going to use a Venn diagram. Instead of two categories, we're going to use three categories and an outsider. Let's see. I'll draw this really big circle. Let's see, how do I make another one congruent to this one? Try this. Try that. And I'm a little out of space. How about this? Okay, you gotta imagine that as a circle, this little thing curving in, but that's all I can draw. Well, the 9 dogs can do none, that's pretty easy. These dogs are the outsiders. Well, the insides, we first gotta label these. Some dogs can sit. Sit will be here. Sit will be here. I'm gonna put stay here. Stay right there, and then we have rollover. I just write roll. We don't have enough to write rollover. We won't have enough space for our numbers. Well, we don't know much about the outside because we can't start with sit, stay, or roll. We can't start with these because all we know is that the whole thing of sit is 50, but the sit thing is split up into 4 different categories, so we don't know how it's split up. But what we do know is that 9 dogs are the super dogs. That's the guys that can do all three. Now it may take you a little while to find a region that has all three categories, but stay isn't here, sit isn't here, so is roll over. So this is where all the super dogs stay. These guys stand here. And, well, sit and stay. Well, we first look at this little oval region here. Well, that, we know, sit and stay. We know that this whole region, these two dots, these two have to sum to 17 because they're the dogs that can sit and stay. So just have, 9 of those 17 dogs can also roll. So we have 17 minus 9, 8 more dogs that can only sit and stay. And can basically do the same thing for all the other categories. We'll look at this one. Well, this one is where we can all the dogs that can sit and roll. Well, let's see, sit and roll, where is that? Sit and roll, 18 of those can sit and roll. Well, 9 of those dogs that can sit and roll, 9 of them can also stay. So we just subtract, 18 from 9, we get 9 again. We get 9 here. Let's take a look at this last region, the last region that's adjacent to this 9. Let's see. Well, here's the part that we can stay and roll. Stay and roll, that's just the middle one, 12 dogs. These two have to sum to 12. So there's, 9 of those dogs can also sit. So you have 12 minus 9, 3 more dogs that can only stay and roll. So we got that down. Now let's move on to the big parts. But the big parts is really easy. Well, sit, these 8 plus 9 plus 9 are also in the sit. So we just subtract the sum of 8, 9, 9, 9 from all dogs that can sit. That's 50. So let's see a little arithmetic. 50. Oh, 9 plus 9 is 18. 18 plus 8 is 26. 50 minus 26 is 24. So I have 24 dogs that can only sit. And now I see where we're going. We're really getting close. 9 plus 3 is 12. 12 plus 8 is 20. Well, it's pretty easy to subtract 29 from 20. That's just 9. Okay, it's not a coincidence that there's 4 nines in this diagram. Okay, not very clear that it's a coincidence. Well, we'll roll over, I should say. There are 34 dogs that can roll over. And of those, 9 plus 9, 18. Add on 3, there's 21 more. They either can sit or stay. So we have 21 minus 34, which is, let's see, 13 more dogs. Okay, now we have to add all these up, and then the outsiders. Something not that good. I have to admit that. Let's see, organized. Take away the 8, and that gave us 17. I'm gonna write down all my steps and numbers from the way. And if I add on 9, well, to add a 9 to any number, we increase the 10 digit by 1 and decrease the 1's digit by 1. We get 26. Let's see, another 9. 10's digit increased by 10. And 1's digit decreased by 1. I mean 10's digit increased by 1. Let's see. Well, can add on my 3 next. Well, 3 plus 35 is pretty obvious. That's 38. Got that down, cross that off. Just crossing off the way we go. That way we don't count anymore more than once. And 13 and 24 for the large numbers. Well, 13 plus 36 is 49. I mean, 13 plus 38, so it wasn't very clear. That will be 51. 51, we can check that out real quick. 8 plus 3 is 11. That ends in the digit 1. We're pretty sure we're right. 51 ends in 1. And 24, finally, got that down. Add that. We get 75. Now, before we circle 75 and move on, we have to include the outsiders. Even though these dogs are pretty poor, they're still dogs. They're still dogs, like how we are all human. So we add on 9, increase the 10 digit by 1. I'm gonna write the answer one more on. Outstanding. And we increase the 10 digit by 1 and decrease the 1 digit by 1, and we get 84 as our answer.